Hey, what's up guys? Today we are going to compare some of the mid-range chipsets which are going to power the phones of 2020 with some of the existing chipsets. This is to say, we are going to compare Snapdragon 765G, 730G and Helio G90T. I did not include the regular versions as they are underclocked with few less features but closely match with their gaming chipset counterparts. Anyways, I will include Snapdragon 765 and 730 for some comparisons but will not cover them exclusively. Anyhow, if you end up liking the video, then do consider subscribing. And now, let's begin. The Snapdragon 765 series has seen a switch to a new Samsung 7nm EUV fabrication process, which is a decent improvement compared to last year's 8nm of the Snapdragon 730 series. But MediaTek Helio G90T lags behind with 12nm FinFET process, which means Snapdragon 765 series is much more battery efficient with better performance. The CPU structure has been changed for Snapdragon 765 series, but it still uses Cortex A76 cores, which is disappointing. But they will receive a small to moderate frequency bump with the two performance cores operating at different frequencies. There's a prime core that goes up to 2.4 GHz in the Snapdragon 765G and 2.3 GHz in the Snapdragon 765, and another performance core that reaches 2.2 GHz on both bins. The 6 Cortex A55 based efficiency cores still go to 1.8 GHz. Thus, the core cluster configuration of the Snapdragon 765G is 1+1+6 compared to 2+6 on the Snapdragon 730G. The Snapdragon 730 and 730G use Cortex A76 based Kryo 460 cores, 2 powerful Kryo 470 cores clocked at 2.2 GHz and 6 low powered Kryo 470 cores clocked at 1.8 GHz. In comparison, the MediaTek Helio G90T uses 2 A76 cores clocked at 2.05 GHz, however its 6 low powerful A55 cores are clocked higher at 2 GHz. The Snapdragon 765 and 765G has been upgraded to Adreno 620 GPU. We don't know too much about this, but Qualcomm claims a 20% improvement in performance with the Snapdragon 765 and 38% improvement with the Snapdragon 765G over Snapdragon 730 series chipsets. The MediaTek Helio G90T uses a Mali G76 MP4 at 800 MHz, and this performed at a similar specs to the Snapdragon 730G, beating it in some benchmarks and losing in others. So it is likely that Snapdragon 765G will easily take the lead here. The new Snapdragon 765 chipset features the Hexagon 696 DSP, upgrading it from the Hexagon 688 on the Snapdragon 730G. The 5th generation AI engine on Snapdragon 765G offers 5.5 TOPS, that is tera operations per second, across all the process on the chipset, that is CPU, GPU, HVX and Tensor. A discrete component called the Qualcomm Sensing Hub has also been announced that assists voice assistants to better work in busy environments. Qualcomm doubled the AI performance on the Snapdragon 730 versus Snapdragon 710 by introducing their 4th generation AI engine, adding more ALUs in the GPU, improving dot product instruction performance in the CPU, and adding their Hexagon Tensor Accelerator. But it does not stand chance against Snapdragon 765G. In comparison, the dual APU of the MediaTek Helio G90T is rated at 1 TOPS total performance. The on-display resolution on Snapdragon 765 powered phone will support Quad HD Plus with 60Hz refresh rate and Full HD Plus resolution with 120Hz refresh rate. The Snapdragon 730 supports display up to 2520x1080 pixels, with the Snapdragon 730G compatible with Quad HD Plus, that is 3360x1440 resolution. Qualcomm confirmed to XDA that the GPU in the Snapdragon 730 is already capable of supporting Full HD Plus at 120Hz. In the case of Helio G90T, it supports 21:9 Full HD Plus display with a maximum resolution of up to 2400x1080 pixels. It also supports display with 90Hz refresh rate. While the Spectra ISP in the Snapdragon 800 series has received a huge bump in performance and functionality with this generation, the improvement in the Snapdragon 700 series are more of a low-key. The Spectra 355 ISP on Snapdragon 765G allows the chipset to support single camera of up to 192MP and dual camera of 22+22MP. Snapdragon 730 series processor supports up to 48MP single camera, which can be enhanced up to 192MP using different techniques and 22+22MP dual cameras. For Helio G90T, it has 3 ISP which allows it to support up to 64MP single camera and dual cameras up to 24+16MP. Snapdragon 765G chipset carries support for up to dual 16-bit 12GB of LPDDR4X RAM at 2133MHz, and Snapdragon 730G supports dual 16-bit 8GB of LPDDR4 RAM at 1866MHz. There is no LPDDR5 on Snapdragon 765 series. Helio G90T supports LPDDR4X RAM as well, and with up to 10GB operating at 2133MHz. Now let's dive into its connectivity features. Here clearly Snapdragon 765G will take on both Snapdragon 730G and Helio G90T with its 5G connectivity. The Snapdragon 765 and 765G are both integrated with X52 5G modem that promises 3.7 Gbps 5G download speeds and 1.6 Gbps 5G upload speeds over sub 6GHz and mmWave. Snapdragon X52 offers half the maximum theoretical 5G download speed of X55 modem found in Snapdragon 865. And on 4G LTE, the downlink is 1.2 Gbps and uplink is 210 Mbps. Snapdragon 730G gets X15 LTE modem which supports downlink of 800 Mbps and uplink of 150 Mbps. And finally, the Helio G90T uses Cat dual modem with download speed of 600 Mbps and Cat link modem with upload speed of 150 Mbps. The Snapdragon 765G has huge improvements in CPU, GPU, AI capabilities and network connectivity. It is almost the largest upgrade of the Qualcomm 7 series since its introduction. With the NSA-SA dual mode 5G, the comprehensive capabilities are much higher than in the past. So that's it for today. I tried to make the video as concise as possible. If I gave some wrong information or if I missed out something, then do comment, let others know, and I will see you in the next one. Peace out.